This video is brought to you by Magellan TV. If you've never been a documentary lover, we at Simple History are here to change your mind and blow away any doubts. Join us and start enjoying the outstanding on-demand video streaming service, Magellan TV. It was founded by documentary filmmakers where new content is added every week, letting you explore over 3,000 masterpiece documentaries, movies, and series in 4K resolution. Enrich your historical knowledge by watching Magellan TV's documentary about Joseph Stalin, Russia's steel tyrant. Enjoy this amazing documentary with pure history facts, photos, and authentic videos. Witness this intriguing story about Joseph Stalin, the man of steel who ruthlessly dominated the Soviet Union. After the death of Lenin and the ensuing power struggle, Stalin was the one who emerged victorious and continued his iron fist reign until the day he died. Even though he is considered one of the most heartless and infamous dictators, Stalin was the crucial ally in the fight against Nazi Germany. By using the link in the description, Simple History viewers can take advantage of a special holiday offer, a buy one, get one free gift card for an annual membership. Click on the link in the description to try Magellan TV now. A day in the life of Stalin. Joseph Stalin, originally Ios Besaryones Dzejuyageshvili, was born in the small Georgian town of Gori in December of 1878. He grew up poor but excelled at school. After a brief stint in a seminary, Joseph became interested in socialist politics, inspired by the writings of Karl Marx. By 1912, Vladimir Lenin, who he had first met in 1905 at a Bolshevik conference in Tammerfors, Finland, had made him a member of the Bolshevik Central Committee. This paved the way for him to play a key role in the Bolshevik uprising of 1917, which brought about the demise of the Tsarist Russia and ultimately led to the establishment of the USSR in 1922. After the death of Lenin in 1924 and the ensuing power struggle, it was Stalin who emerged victorious, ruling the USSR with an iron fist until his death in 1953. It's believed that Stalin was responsible for the deaths of at least 6 million people, while some scholars have argued that the figure was closer to 20 million. Stalin is, therefore, considered to have been one of the most ruthless and notorious dictators of the 20th century. Despite the brutality of his regime and the violence often shown towards those who lived under its authority, Stalin was a crucial ally in the fight against Nazi Germany. Without the Soviet Union's role in World War II, it's very likely that the Allies would have failed in their attempt to liberate Europe from the Axis powers. At the outbreak of the so-called Great Patriotic War, Stalin increased his workday significantly. According to Field Marshal Georgi Zhukov, Stalin worked as many as 15 hours a day and took no less than 5 leading positions upon himself. These responsible roles included Supreme Commander, General Secretary of the Central Committee of the All-Union Communist Party, Chairman of the Council of People's Commissars of the Soviet Union, Head of the State Defense Committee, and People's Commissar of Defense. Aware of the mounting stress on the Supreme Commander, Zhukov was cleverly able to gauge Stalin's mood. When drawing deeply on his pipe, it meant he was in a good mood. If, however, Stalin failed to light his pipe once it was out of tobacco, it was a sign of impending anger. This understanding allowed Zhukov to deal with Stalin in a way that the other generals couldn't. It's believed that Stalin suffered from insomnia and was not an early riser. He often slept in his clothes, on a military-style camp bed in his personal residence, the Kunstvordacha. Failing any earlier emergencies that required his immediate attention, he usually rose at about 11 a.m. to receive the first reports on how the war was progressing. Stalin would have a light breakfast before spending several hours working, which involved taking reports, issuing orders, and conducting meetings either at his home in Kuntsevo or at the Kremlin. Twice a day at noon and 9 p.m., he received updates from his Stavka plenipotentiaries, men who were directly overseeing the war effort. Failure to submit these reports was met by a harsh rebuke from the Supreme Leader, often in the form of threats against their position within the government and even against their lives. In the early hours of the evening, Stalin would head to his office, known to the regime insiders as the Little Corner, which was on the second floor of the Kremlin. From here, he would run sessions of the GKO, the Soviet State Defense Committee, which can be best compared to a war cabinet. These sessions would go on for many hours, sometimes not ending until well into the night. This was a particularly tense time of day for Stalin's underlings, both military and civilian. The dictator's paranoia became increasingly worse throughout his reign, and entry to the little corner was tightly controlled. No weapons were permitted, and everyone, no matter their rank, had to carry their identification papers. Visitors were encouraged to never disagree with Stalin, not to engage in small talk, and to leave his presence quickly once they had finished giving their report. The threat of arrest was ever present. At the end of Stalin's heavy work day, he would frequently invite other high-ranking members of the regime to join him for dinner at Kuntsevo, often to be followed by a movie. These were not the kind of invitations that could be turned down. After his men were finally allowed to return to their homes for a few hours of much-needed rest, Stalin would end the day reading books before finally going to sleep in the early hours of the morning. Whilst Stalin had the luxury of not having to rise until late into the day, many members of the regime were not so fortunate and had to be ready for work in the early hours in order to ensure that the state ran smoothly. Stalin's control over the lives of those who worked for him, including his generals, was so pervasive that many of them were even given set sleep times. Alexander Vasilevsky, chief of the general staff of the Soviet Armed Forces and deputy minister of defense, for example, was told that he had to be asleep between the hours of 4 a.m. to 10 a.m. Stalin would personally phone him during these times to ensure that his orders were being followed. Such was the extent of Vasilevsky's workload, though, that he was forced to order his staff to lie to Stalin and say that he was resting when he was in fact trying to sneak in a few extra hours of work. In the early years of the war, while there was still a serious threat of defeat by the Germans, Stalin was not a heavy drinker. He also strongly encouraged sobriety in those who worked for him. From 1943 onward, though, this began to change, and Stalin's near-nightly dinners became increasingly drunken events, especially for his men. These affairs usually began late in the afternoon, when Stalin's magnates would receive invitations to join him for dinner. As before, these were not the sort of invitations that could be declined. Over the course of the next 6 hours or so, Stalin's associates were encouraged to drink to excess. Stalin joined in the drinking, although his drinks were often watered down on medical advice. These were not fun social events for the Soviet officials. A single mistaken word could place either themselves or their families in danger. In fact, the statesman Anastas Mikoyan claimed that Stalin forced us to drink to loosen our tongues. The situation became so dire that some of the men were prepared to risk Stalin's anger and attempt to maintain some degree of sobriety through tactics such as sneaking out of the room for naps or having waitresses pour them colored water instead of wine. It was in this atmosphere that a great deal of Soviet state business was done. Throughout the evening, Stalin would continue to issue orders, receive messages, and even approve executions if necessary. According to Field Marshal Zhukov, many decisions relating to the armed forces and the security of the Soviet Union were regulated in these unofficial meetings, as the contingent of the gatherings largely consisted of the USSR's highest-ranking officials. Late into the night, usually around 2 a.m., Stalin would suggest watching a movie, sometimes more than one. He is known to have favored westerns, detective films, and gangster movies. After this, he would sometimes suggest another bite to eat, meaning that his poor, exhausted, and now hungover officials often didn't get home until well past daybreak. As in earlier years, Stalin would end his day reading books before finally falling asleep. This state of affairs continued until March 1, 1953, when Stalin suffered a massive stroke. He lingered on for several days before ultimately passing away on the evening of the 5th. Following the appropriate preparation, his body was then displayed in the famous Hall of Columns for mourners throughout the Soviet Union to visit.